force is strong in my family. My father has it. I have it. My sister has it.
Help you again? Yes.
I got a bad feeling about this.
Darth Vader, only you could be so bold.
I am a Jedi, like my father before me.
No, I am your father.
Saturday night at the movies with Andrew Collins.
Celebrating Star Wars
on Classic FM.
No, I have it, actually. That was a kind of potted history of all of the Star Wars films, in case you're not up to date. A big intergalactic welcome to Classic FM's weekly celebration of cinema. The new Star Wars film, Episode 7, The Force Awakens, is upon us. It's everywhere you look. And it would seem churlish not to devote the next 2 hours to one of cinema's most popular film franchises. Totally reinvigorated, I would say, by the terrific new chapter. Which broke box office records on its first day of release, the biggest single day at the UK box office in history. Beat that. If the cash registers stop ringing at any point, I'll be playing you music from all 7 Star Wars films. As well as playing the music, I've been talking exclusively about the music to director J.J. Abrams, star Harrison Ford, and one of the new young British leads, John Boyega. I saw the film at the European premiere in London on Wednesday, and I can promise you that this show will be spoiler-free. All I'll say is that it's the Star Wars film I was looking for. If you've already seen it, I hope you agree, and that, like me and the audience I saw it with, you cheered when the words "long ago in a galaxy far, far away" filled the screen and this music started.
Thank you.
historic. There's no other word for it. That's the main theme from Star Wars on Classic FM by John Williams, who's conducting the Boston Pops Orchestra. That's taken from the album John Williams Conducts Music from Star Wars. Usually when you hear music from the Star Wars films, it's by the London Symphony Orchestra, Classic FM's orchestra in the city of London. They recorded all of the first six Star Wars scores. So we're going to hear much more from them between now and seven this evening in Saturday Night at the Movies. We also have tracks from John Williams Conducts John Williams, the Star Wars trilogy, which are performed by the Skywalker Symphony Orchestra, who are essentially the house band at Skywalker Sound. The new score was recorded in Los Angeles by a freelance orchestra recruited especially for the job. It was completed in mid-November. Nothing like working up to a deadline. So we begin at the beginning with Episode 4, or simply Star Wars, as it was known in 1977. It finally arrived where I lived, in an East Midlands town far, far away, in April 1978, by which time I was already the film's biggest fan. This will be a more or less chronological journey through the film franchise. We'll hear what J.J. Abrams, Harrison Ford and John Boyega think about John Williams' iconic music too. And I'll play some of your requests. Thanks to everyone who's been in touch across the universe on Twitter. We're at Classic FM if you'd like to get in touch with us there. And online by classicfm.com. Please do continue to send your film reviews and Star Wars comments our way. In the meantime, let's hear Princess Leia's theme from the original Star Wars. Princess Leia's theme on Classic FM from Star Wars by John Williams, who's conducting the Boston Pops Orchestra. Williams was tasked by director George Lucas with providing leitmotifs for the main characters, which he certainly did. That is a regal piece, that. And it also has an emotional layer, I think, for Carrie Fisher's captured rebel, Princess Leia Organa. Iconic is an overused term, but I think it's fair to throw it around when talking about Star Wars. Its music by John Williams is currently placed at number 4 in the Classic FM Movie Music Hall of Fame chart, and you can see the whole chart at classicfm.com. I'm Andrew Collins with a Star Wars special until 7 this evening. I met J.J. Abrams, the boyish director of The Force Awakens, on Thursday to discuss the music from the film series. When I told him that the audience cheered as soon as the music started, I asked how important John Williams' theme is.
It's as important as anything else, and probably more important.
It must be amazing for you to have worked with John Williams. He's scoring your film.
No, it's unbelievable. And the truth is that this entire experience has been one surreal moment after another, nonstop for a few years. Maybe the most surreal was going over to John Williams' house, and just to give some backstory, as a kid, of course this was before downloads or cable TV or electricity, but I would lie on the floor of my room with headphones on listening to scores of films, often films I hadn't seen, and very often scores that John Williams had written, and those were full stories. I mean, I would close my eyes and I would see the whole story. And, you know, I'd look at see what the cue was called and sort of put together what was happening given that, and got it right sometimes and not quite right other times. But the music told the story. So I was a fan of Mr. Williams for most of my life. And going to his house, and he could not be lovelier. He could not be a more modest, humble, kind, sweet man. And he was playing for me on the piano some cues that we were going to record with the orchestra, and just to listen to him play. And he had this giant stack of sheet music that was all written in pencil, and he would pull a different piece of music out and he would look at it, and they were all for the movie, and they were sketches in some cases and more complete score in others. And he would just play, of course, you know, effortlessly, these pieces of music that would, in some cases, make me laugh out loud because I could sort of tell what it would be when a string and brass section were playing something. Or he would play something and I'd almost, you know, start to tear up because I could just feel when those strings would swell. You just knew what it was going to be. And he writes everything in pencil. And I looked over at his bookshelf, and there were these large leather-bound books that were essentially, you know, the greatest American films of the past 40 years. But of course, they were all the films he had scored, and they were the original scores. And I asked him about them, and he said, oh, please, please. And he took, you know, he said, take one down if you want to. And I pulled out the Jaws score.
Right.
And I opened it up, and I looked, and there, in pencil, just exactly like the pages on his piano at the moment, were these notes, you know, bump, 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 bump. And there they were. And it was just, I got chills. I mean, this man has given audiences the profundity that they have experienced over these decades. And when you watch moments like Luke Skywalker looking out at the twin sun setting, and you turn the volume down, tell me what that experience is. It is an absolutely different experience than with that soundtrack up. And of course, that's the same with almost any scene of any movie he's scored.
Thank you.
A favourite piece from the original Star Wars film of J.J. Abrams, the director and co-writer of the new one, The Force Awakens. That was Binary Sunset from Star Wars, conducted by John Williams and the London Symphony Orchestra. That, if you haven't seen the film, is an epic vision of the planet called Tatooine's two suns. It's a planet with two suns. And Luke Skywalker, our new hero, looks beyond his life on a farm boy's wages at this amazing sight. Now, we know that it's one of J.J. Abrams' favourite cues. It was also chosen by listener Nathaniel Reed in Gloucester, who also wants anything from The Force Awakens. We'll hear music from the new film later on and find out what John Boyega, Harrison Ford and J.J. Abrams think about it. First, though, another of Nathaniel's requests, as chosen also by Anthony Judd in Staffordshire. Anthony got in touch via classicfm.com to say, one of my favourite pieces of music from the Star Wars saga is the asteroid field from The Empire Strikes Back, the second film. The wonderful piece from John Williams' score perfectly fits the scene where TIE fighters pursue Han Solo, Princess Leia, Chewbacca and C-3PO in the Millennium Falcon. Just one fantastic scene, he says, from what is arguably the greatest Star Wars film yet. We'll be right back. Always enjoyable to hear that. The Asteroid Field from The Empire Strikes Back by John Williams. He's conducting the Skywalker Symphony Orchestra there. I just love the choppiness of that. It's percussive, isn't it? And really conjures the assault course through those asteroids. I'm pretty sure that's Simon Pegg's favourite cue from the Star Wars film franchise. He's told Classic FM before that The Empire Strikes Back is his favourite film score of all time. He has a small role in The Force Awakens, but I won't ruin it for you if you haven't yet seen the film. I asked director J.J. Abrams about the use of music within Episode 7, because when I watched it, it struck me as pretty much a constant throughout the film.
It's there quite a bit. I mean, there are scenes where it's absent. In fact, there are scenes where we chose not to use music that he had written simply because it felt like there was so much music that we didn't want a wall-to-wall experience. And so when there was an opportunity to say, we're pulling it out here, we're taking it out there, we did. But certainly there is an enormous amount of music, as Star Wars always has. In fact, John even sort of references these movies as musicals.
That was Yoda's theme on Classic FM from the second Star Wars movie, The Empire Strikes Back, by John Williams, conducting the Skywalker Symphony Orchestra. It's ripe with wonder and wisdom and a little Muppet mischief, I like to think. It's another leitmotif, which is basically a melodic phrase for individual characters or story elements, something John Williams loves to do in this saga. It was a technique used by early film composers like Max Steiner, Eric Korngold and Franz Waxman, also Alfred Newman, Bernard Herrmann, and Williams, though, I would call the master of the modern leitmotif. We'll have another of them, the Imperial March, also known as Darth Vader's theme, next on Classic FM. ¶¶
Wrap up your Christmas shopping at M&S. There's 30% off selected clothing and homeware, so you're bound to find that special something for a special someone. Offers continue until 24th of December. Only M&S. See selected stores and online for details, subject to availability.
Susie Perry here, queen of tech and car lover. If you're driving home for Christmas, treat yourself to a digital radio in your car. There's loads of digital radios and adapters ready to fit into any car, so you can listen to all your favourites plus extra digital stations.
Visit your local car dealer or car accessory retailer and look for the digital tick.
If you love radio, go digital.
Martin Shaw on Drama.
The definition of drama is conflict, and the more intelligent the conflict, then the better the drama. What was wonderful for me about playing Dean is he's a man that is infinitely more intelligent and articulate than I am, and so I just got to feel like I was an intellectual.
Great actors make great drama. Watch Judge John Deed every night at 8 on Drama. Freeview Channel 20, Sky and Virgin.
There's only one channel called Drama.
Joshua Bell and the Academy of St. Martin in the Fields. See them live at Symphony Hall, Birmingham in January. Visit thsh.co.uk.
Bring joy to your world with your very own carol or your first Noel and spend the season walking in the air. Have yourself a merry little Christmas by finding love, harmony and friendship with Classic FM Romance. Get started today at classicfm.com/romance.
Delve into the extraordinary story of the Strauss family. The Last Waltz, the new book by John Suchet. Available now at Waterstones.
This week, the Sunday Times brings Hollywood glamour to the festive season. In our exclusive interview, movie maverick Quentin Tarantino discusses his career and upcoming film, The Hateful Eight. Plus, don't miss our bumper two-week guide to the best festive TV, covering the whole of the holiday season. Only in the Sunday Times this weekend.
Hello, I'm Ian McKellen. I want you to join me in supporting Crisis this Christmas. Times are tough. While we're safe and warm inside, thousands of homeless people will be sleeping on the freezing streets. For just £22.29, you can reserve a place for someone at Crisis at Christmas. You'll give them food, clothes and safety, and the chance to move off the streets for good. So, please, go to crisis.org.uk and give £22.29 to bring someone in from the cold. Thank you.
I've got you a good one this year, Matt. You know you're always disappearing off on stag do's and whatnot? Well, I found this holdall, and I think it's about time you had something a bit more stylish than that knackered old rucksack. Love, your favourite big sister. Found it at Debenhams.
Saturday night at the movies with Andrew Collins.
Celebrating Star Wars.
Classic FM.
Ah, yes, it stirs the blood and stiffens the resolve if you happen to be involved in a battle between good and evil, as so many of us are. That was the Imperial March, or Darth Vader's theme from The Empire Strikes Back on Classic FM. John Williams once again conducting the Skywalker Symphony Orchestra. That was chosen by Rebecca Helmore in North Wales, who wrote to me at classicfm.com to say it's one of my favourite iconic pieces from the superb John Williams soundtracks. Whatever I'm doing, she says, when I hear that piece, I stop and listen and smile. Well, who knows, Rebecca, maybe Lord Vader is also smiling. He always has a mask on. It's very difficult to tell. When I met Harrison Ford on Thursday, I was keen to hear what he makes of John Williams' music. After all, as Han Solo, and in another series of films, Indiana Jones, he's been blessed by Williams' fanfares on several occasions. But first, we spoke about the overall power of music, and film music at that.
You don't have to have musical capacity to have it work through your emotional system, and that music can generate in you feelings that you didn't even know you had. The grace to have in your emotional complexity.
And would you agree that that film music, orchestral music for film, yes, should be placed on as high a level as any great classical music? Just because it's modern and it's for film, some people think that it's not proper classical music.
Oh, I don't know why how you could think that. I'm sure that you know, there are all kinds of music, and some of it is crude, but all of it is about human emotion, and trying to tell stories with music. And whether it's opera or folk music or the rudest kind of street banging on a drum, we need stories to help us interpret the world around us. I mean, this is what human beings do, is they make stuff up to tell each other from the earliest days. And music is a way of communicating emotionally.
And you've been blessed twice over, really. As Indiana Jones,
more
you've got
times,
you've got your own fanfare.
More times than that, by the scale of talent of John Williams, yeah.
So do you hear his fanfare sometimes when you walk out of your front door in the morning?
No, but sometimes, but I hear it all the time in my life. I am often introduced with John Williams' music to accompany me, which is not a bad thing to have happen.
Listening back to my conversation with Harrison Ford, of the two voices I hear, his is the one I'd rather have. Here's another cue from The Empire Strikes Back on Classic FM, The Clash of Lightsabers. It starts quietly, but gradually builds into action.
Thank you.
feel the tension. With John Williams, even the action cues have a depth of emotion to them. That was The Clash of Lightsabers from The Empire Strikes Back by Mr. Williams. He's also conducting on Classic FM. We'll move now to the third film in the series, Return of the Jedi, the conclusion of the first story arc. The new trilogy begins 30 years later. I remember seeing The Return of the Jedi vividly in 1983. I was a more self-conscious 18-year-old by then, but still captivated by Han Solo in particular, and prepared to put up with the Ewoks, the cuddly creatures who appear in this sequence, The Forest Battle.
Such
brilliantly powerful music, The Forest Battle from Return of the Jedi by John Williams. You're listening to Classic FM. I'm Andrew Collins, and we're enjoying a Star Wars special edition of Saturday Night at the Movies. I'd read that Harrison Ford had asked for his character Han Solo to be killed off in Return of the Jedi, and I was curious to find out why.
Well, it seemed that this, you know, the utility of the character was understood by me to be the sort of ironic voice for the audience, to hold myself at a you know, an ironic distance from the mythology and the belief, so that I might have some place to go. And I thought if I were to sacrifice myself in character to the story at the end of the first three films, I might have been ultimately more emotionally useful than if I didn't die.
The stars of the original Star Wars, including Harrison Ford, Mark Hamill and Carrie Fisher, were not well known at the time, although of course went on to be. J.J. Abrams follows this tradition through to The Force Awakens, which he directed, with two relatively unknown Brits in the lead roles. Daisy Ridley plays a scavenger on the desert planet Jakku, who is drawn into the story when she meets Finn, a stormtrooper with a conscience, played by John Boyega. He's only 23, but a massive fan of the Star Wars music and film soundtracks in general, telling us about his love for composers Hans Zimmer and Harry Gregson-Williams. Naturally, I was keen to find out if he had a particular favourite amongst all of the Star Wars cues.
Ewok celebration song.
Oh, yeah, I love that.
That is the song right there.
That is good.
You know what? If you play that song when you're on a treadmill, it makes you bounce. It makes your stride look so elegant. Also, it's just quite fun to listen to.
It is, yeah. I think you've marked yourself out there as a true enthusiast.
Yes, yeah. I love a good score.
You don't just go with the flow and go with the big tunes.
Yeah, you have to experience the other tunes of Star Wars.
How do you feel, and this is one for music lovers everywhere, how do you feel about the Cantina Band tune in the first film?
There are two different versions to that, though, aren't there? Mm. There's the normal one, which doesn't have the singing alien in it, and then there's the second one, which is quite enhanced. Yeah, I like the first one. It's just simple, and it sounds raw. It sounds alien. And the instrument sounds like instruments you haven't heard before, and I definitely think that was on purpose.
Yeah.
We have a cantina scene in Force Awakens, and The music is very different, and but yet the tone suits the environment.
It's so more of a kind of reggae tune, really.
Yeah.
Two pieces back to back that show the incredible depth and ability of the London Symphony Orchestra, who are Classic FM's orchestra in the City of London, conducted there by John Williams, and playing first of all from Return of the Jedi, Victory Celebration for the Ewoks, and from Star Wars A New Hope, the Cantina Band tune. Still to come in our Star Wars special, more from Harrison Ford, J.J. Abrams and the enthusiastic John Boyega, and we'll hear music from the brand new film, The Force Awakens. But next, we're entering the world of The Phantom Menace. Put all your thoughts about the movie to one side, as the music is absolutely peerless.
This week, the Sunday Times brings Hollywood glamour to the festive season. In our exclusive interview, movie maverick Quentin Tarantino discusses his career and upcoming film, The Hateful Eight. Plus, don't miss our bumper two-week guide to the best festive TV, covering the whole of the holiday season. Only in the Sunday Times this weekend.
Soph, shopping for underwear is not easy. I must have looked like a right idiot stood there in amongst all the bras and knickers. Good job the shop assistant saved me. And I think, this year, I might have finally got it right. Merry Christmas. Love, Rob. Found it at Debenhams.
Vodafone have a fantastic range of gift bundles available this Christmas. Like our pay-as-you-go bundle with... That's right, Terry. A Vodafone Smart Speed 6 plus 50 gigabytes of UK data and... a Gecko speaker. What did you just say? Oh, Terry. You're flying without wings. Get your bundle in store today and get closer to the ones you love this Christmas. Vodafone, power to you. That's right, terms apply.
Okay, here we go.
When you put your Elvis Presley.
With the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra.
If I Can Dream,
the new album. This is Elvis, as you've never heard him before. If I Can Dream, the number one album.
Welcome to Sounds Fantastic. Now, can you identify this sound? That was a hippopotamus accidentally tripping over a harpsichord. Now, what about this sound?
Go compare.
Yeah, that's the sound that's already helped millions of people save money on their car insurance.
He's where you go to insure your motor. Nothing quite compares to Go Compare.
Sounds fantastic.
Bring joy to your world with your very own carol or your first Noel and spend the season walking in the air. Have yourself a merry little Christmas by finding love, harmony, and friendship with Classic FM Romance. Get started today at classicfm.com/romance.
Wrap up your Christmas shopping at M&S. There's 30% off selected clothing and homeware, so you're bound to find that special something for a special someone. Offers continue until 24th of December. Only M&S. See selected stores and online for details, subject to availability.
Force is strong in my family. My father has it. I have it. My sister has it.
Help Dragon! Yes!
I got a bad feeling about this.
Darth Vader, if only you could be so bold.
I am a Jedi. Like my father before me.
No. I am your father.
No!
Saturday night at the movies with Andrew Collins.
Celebrating Star Wars
on Classic FM.
The Force is strong on the programme tonight. Thank you for joining us in hyperspace here for this Star Wars spectacular. Still to come, music from the new film, The Force Awakens, and more from our special guests about John Williams' unbeatable music. But right now, let's enter the second trilogy. Whatever you might think of Jar Jar Binks and green screens, you can't deny that this is John Williams at the top of his game.
Duel of the Fates from The Phantom Menace by John Williams. You heard the London Symphony Orchestra there, conducted by John Williams and the London Voices. A truly blood-rushing use of the choir, I think, which recalls a satanic horror movie from the 1970s for me. It's actually a Welsh poem sung in Sanskrit, that old standby. So from the same film here on Classic FM, this is Anakin's theme. The theme reflects hope, a sort of prelapsarian innocence and boyish wonder for the young boy Anakin, although we see his future, so we know something serious is coming. It's all going to get very dark, or very Darth. Anakin's theme from The Phantom Menace by John Williams here on Classic FM. When I met Harrison Ford on Thursday, I asked him whether it's distracting as an actor to not be able to hear the music when shooting the scenes because it's added afterwards.
Ah, well, that's interesting because when we were doing Indiana Jones, there were several scenes which were basically silent movie scenes. There were two or three scenes where there were no words. And I asked Steven Spielberg if we could have music, and that I behaved the story to music. And we once had a string quartet come in and play music. Wow. While I pantomimed without. But the music had no reference to the story. It was just a tempo, and it was the meter, and it was the surprise of the music. Which I used to generate faces, basically. I made faces and behavior and human behaviors to the music, and it's usually done after, but it helped give me a kind of energy and a power that I didn't have on my own. to inhabit the story in those scenes.
Harrison Ford's young co-star John Boyega is also all too aware of how music can elevate a scene.
As an actor on set, all you see is the dailies, and the dailies don't have the music and the feel for things. The music just does something. It makes you feel a way about the scene and the circumstance, especially when it's timed right in a movie. It's a perfect balance between obviously the action and the scenes and the sounds, and then just the feeling. Like, the music is supposed to be like a mirror of the feeling and the tones behind the scene, and I love it.
We move now to the second of the prequel trilogy in Star Wars, Attack of the Clones, and my favourite tune from it, Across the Stars, the love theme.
That's the love theme from Attack of the Clones, also known as Across the Stars, with John Williams conducting the London Symphony Orchestra. It's a romantic journey that has shades of Superman for me, in which John Williams sent Clark Kent and Lois across the stars. Thank you for all your tweets at Classic FM and your messages to classicfm.com. Please do keep them coming. We love to hear from you. Now, to what was, until this week, the most recently theatrically released Star Wars film, Revenge of the Sith. Amazingly, it turned 10 years old in May this year. Here's the episode's best-loved piece of music, Battle of the Heroes. Amazing. That's Battle of the Heroes from Revenge of the Sith by John Williams. Like Duel of the Fates from The Phantom Menace, which we heard earlier on, it incorporates a chorus to enhance the drama. George Lucas actually asked John Williams for an equivalent of Duel of the Fates from The Phantom Menace, and Williams certainly delivered. I think we can all agree on that. I asked director J.J. Abrams, self-confessed fan of Star Wars and of John Williams, whether he has a particular favourite cue from the series. A tough question, I know.
What's incredible about what John does is he writes these cues, and not all of them, but many, have A and B themes in them. So you have the central theme, and then you have this secondary theme, And what's incredible is they're both the theme, and the fact that they coexist is one of his remarkable gifts. I mean, I will tell you that most composers, if they ever could even do one of those themes, would just do that one theme and have a kind of secondary passage that would lead you back to that primary theme. But he is able to combine both. I mean, if you listen to the, for example, the Jurassic Park theme, it begins with this incredible, very specific, memorable score, and you go, oh, of course, that's the Jurassic Park theme. But then it moves into the secondary piece, and you go, oh, no, that's the Jurassic Park theme. But they're both the Jurassic Park theme. So there's a level of incredible complexity, but also emotion that he's somehow able to tap into. I think my favorite moment is that Twin Sunset moment where that the force cue plays. But when you hear, you know, the cues when we're on the stage and he's conducting a cue where, you know, Leia's theme comes in, or you hear the reference to the sort of Millennium Falcon fanfare, and you know, there are so many places that are kind of you think, well, that's my favorite. No, that's my favorite.
What J.J. Abrams is essentially saying is that there's only one John Williams. So before we turn to the music from The Force Awakens, here's another of our selections from Revenge of the Sith. It's Enter Lord Vader, and I think you can imagine what goes on here.
Thank you.
The dark side magnificently embodied by swirling portent there in Enter Lord Vader from Revenge of the Sith by John Williams on Classic FM. I'm Andrew Collins, with you until 7 with our Star Wars special. And then our very own Dark Lord, not that dark actually, Alex James, will be here to take a look at the big events and anniversaries in the classical music world for the week ahead in Alex James's Date Night. We'll turn to the brand new score for The Force Awakens in just a moment. But first, here's J.J. Abrams again to whet our appetite.
He did this amazing theme for the Resistance in this film, which is basically what the rebellion has become. And he did the secondary theme that was for specifically for Poe, who's the pilot for the Resistance. And to hear these two themes coexist is an incredible thing. And in fact, when we went back, we re-recorded the end titles. He incorporated Poe's theme in that area with the Resistance theme where it hadn't been before. And it was, again, one of those moments of just being blown away that someone who was so talented and so seemingly, you know, endlessly brilliant improved upon something that anyone else would say, well, that was, I worked my whole career for this moment. And for John, it was not good enough.
There's a lot of love in the room, and we'll hear March of the Resistance next on Classic FM.
Vodafone have a fantastic range of gift bundles available this Christmas. Like our Music Lovers Bundle with... That's right, Terry. A Samsung Galaxy S6 plus Spotify Premium and... Your Beats headphones. What was that? All right. You're flying without wings. Get closer to the ones you love this Christmas. Vodafone. Power to you.
Minimum term agreements and credit check apply.
Wrap up your Christmas shopping at M&S. There's 30% off selected clothing and homeware, so you're bound to find that special something for a special someone. Offers continue until 24th of December. Only M&S. See selected stores and online for details, subject to availability.
We're getting closer, and it won't be long before you're unwrapping your presents. Yesterday was day 18 of Cadbury's biggest ever advent calendar. What wonderful Christmas deliciousness was unveiled?
On the 18th day of Christmas, Cadbury gave to me...
treats for everyone on our road. Amazing!
And some Cadbury chocolate for me.
Doors have been opening throughout December, so visit the Cadbury YouTube channel to see the hashtag Cadvent Surprises so far.
Hello, I'm Ian McKellen. I want you to join me in supporting Crisis this Christmas. Times are tough. While we are safe and warm inside, thousands of homeless people will be sleeping on the freezing streets. For just £22.29, you can reserve a place for someone at Crisis at Christmas. You'll give them food, clothes and safety, and the chance to move off the streets for good. So, please, go to crisis.org.uk and give £22.29 to bring someone in from the cold. Thank you.
Saturday Night at the Movies with Andrew Collins.
Celebrating Star Wars.
Classic FM. We'll be right back.
From the score to the brand new Star Wars movie, The Force Awakens, that was March of the Resistance by John Williams. The orchestra conducted by special guest conductor Gustavo Dudamel, who also does two other tracks on the score. If you play that next to the Imperial March, which is essentially the theme to the baddies, that sounds very doomy and gloomy and totalitarian. But this one, the March of the Resistance, sounds noble and righteous, as indeed it should be, because they're the goodies. New cast member John Boyega was lucky enough to be there during the recording process.
Well, that was fantastic. I drove to the Fox lot and met John Williams, said hi to the orchestra, who were drawn together as one over the course of a few days. They didn't know each other, so they were literally working on the music notes. They were just reading the music and just doing it and finding a natural balance. So for me, that's really cool.
Yeah, it's quite interesting.
That. But the way he led them, it was really, it was quite something. He was impressed by how fast they was. His notes were straight to the point. I mean, some of the stuff I didn't understand. I mean, I only listened to the stuff. But it was good to see that they were working in unison, and it sounded great. Yeah,
that's quite a skill to get people who haven't worked together for like, to sound like an orchestra.
Literally, they were just like, hey, nice to meet you. Okay, let's play this.
So how did it feel deep inside when you were actually hearing this stuff live?
I just wanted to get a lightsaber, swing it around.
So let's hear another cue from The Force Awakens. This is Rey's theme on Classic FM. From The Force Awakens, that's Rey's theme on Classic FM by John Williams. It sounds quite magical, doesn't it? Which is odd, as Rey, played by Daisy Ridley, is a very earthy character when we first meet her. I met her in August, and she told me that she's not a lifelong Star Wars fan, or certainly didn't grow up as one. I bet she is now. You can watch John Williams conducting the score for The Force Awakens online at classicfm.com. And John Boyega was so taken with being present at the recording session that he had an idea.
What I want to do is I want to put John Williams on a moving bus, and what he can do is follow me with a full orchestra and just score my whole day. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So while this part is going on, it could be, you know, like the Han and Leia love theme going on.
Yeah, I like that. That would be good.
That would be all right.
It would change the whole interview.
I mean, it would. It would. I mean, I would have to get a deeper voice. Deeper voice.
Who are you going to be out of the two? You didn't specify.
Look, I'll be Han, mate. Obviously, well, I am the Han.
I think you'll find that I'm older than you, so I should be Han.
We're going to have to fight about that.
That was Han and Leia from The Force Awakens by John Williams on Classic FM. I like to think of it as a grown-up love theme. It's built on trust, I think, and mutual understanding. But, of course, there's obviously sadness there somewhere down the line. So let's round up our Star Wars special with Han Solo himself, Harrison Ford. I asked him how he felt when he first saw The Force Awakens with the music.
I felt blessed. I felt good. But the first time I heard John Williams' music was in the first Star Wars film. And we had made the film without seeing special effects or any of the visual aspects of the film completed. And when the title credits were rolling off into the horizon, Dolby Sound had just been introduced, and we had this the luxury of this incredible sound system. And the credits rolled off to John's music, and then this great scale of that ship came in over the audience and off into that horizon. And the power of the music and the visual together were transformative, not just for me, but for basically for film as a language. It was unbelievable.
It kind of, people do say it changed the face of
it
cinema.
It did. And I was lucky enough to be an innocent bystander.
Thank you.
From the score to The Force Awakens, that was The Jedi Steps going into the finale by John Williams. The orchestra conducted by John Williams and William Ross. As J.J. Abrams said earlier in the show, it incorporates some of the new themes as well as some of the old. I saw Mr. Williams interviewed at the US premiere. He didn't come over for the European one, but he said he still gets a buzz from being involved in this, which is great to hear. He also said it's a bit like adding a new paragraph to a letter he's been writing for 40 years. I hope you've enjoyed our Star Wars special. If you're going to see The Force Awakens over the next week, perhaps for the second or third time, have a cosmic time, and I look forward to joining you on Boxing Day as we look back on 2015 in movie music. We'll feature the big award winners and box office hits, plus some of our own personal favourites too. In the meantime, all that leaves me to say is have a very Merry Christmas, may the Force be with you, and Alex James, our very own Skywalker, is up next to take us all out on a date.
By the beautiful Blue Danube, an instantly recognisable tune. But when you hear it, you don't picture a country descending into chaos. The Strauss family were the most prolific composers in history, yet as they wrote their waltzes and the Viennese drank champagne, their country hurtled towards war. In his new book, The Last Waltz, John Suchet uncovers the gripping true story of the Strauss dynasty and the times they lived in. Available now at Waterstones and waterstones.com. The Last Waltz by John Suchet.
Deck the halls with Christmas trees, lights and decorations. Because right now at B&Q, we've got clearance offers across the entire Christmas range. That includes 500 price reductions. So get down to B&Q this weekend and unleash a cracking Christmas. Because price is just the beginning. Some stores excluded. See DIY.com for details.
It's a new day. You've decided to make some life changes, including ridding yourself of dentures. Start a new era with dental implants. Darwood and Tanner and their range of dental implant treatments could improve the quality of your life and give you the smile you deserve. Even if you don't have enough bone for regular implants, they could still help. Speak to Darwood and Tanner on 08448 112 926 to arrange a consultation or visit whenyousmile.com.
The swollen red sun disappeared beneath the western hills of Avalon, casting a monstrous shadow upon the castle walls where the heads of dragons once hung.